He led you outside. This game fucking sucks. Just makes me wish for something better to do. Other than fighting Lucas Bratton, of course. What the fuck?
Shades! Shades, come in!
Sergeant, what's the situation?
Oh, thank God, we're under attack. It's a fucking massacre out here. It's Bratton!
Him again?
Broke through our defenses and he's headed inside the base. What do we do, boss?
We move to Plan B.
Okay, but hurry! This guy's a fucking one-man army!
I just do what I do best.
Of course, this asshole just has to come along and ruin my damn day.
Well, he's got somewhere else awaiting. Save this weapon for a good opportunity, and now's that opportunity. Going down, asshole. Yes. Yes. I've been waiting to see what this thing can do. And now, let's take a good look. Yeah. You wish. Do you have any idea how much you spoil my day? I couldn't give a shit about your day, Shades. Besides, you look better without them shades on anyways. You do know you're in possession of CIA equipment. Give me the multiverse gateway device. Who cares what those CIA boys think about this? But let me tell you something, Shades. This war has gone on long enough. All the bloodshed. It's all led to this moment. The end of the line. Lucas versus Shades. And now? It's time to finish this. Once and for all. The end. Begins with you.
With me?
No. With us. Because with this, the multiverse is gonna be mine, Bratton. I'm gonna rule the whole thing. And maybe form an alliance with the other villains. I can't let you do that. But I'm going to. Boys. Kill him.
Yes, sir!
I'm coming for you, Shades.
Come on, baby. Don't feel the
Baby, take my hand. Don't fear the reaper. We'll be able to fly. Don't fear the reaper. Baby, I'm your man.
Morning, Halcyon. Another day in the fuck house. So as you may know, Richie Shades took over the multiverse. I tried to stop him, but clearly that didn't work out in the end. So I've came to you for advice. But first, I think it's best I run you over what he's done.
When Shades took over the multiverse, he enslaved all of its inhabitants. He stored them in prisons, killed some of them. Anyone who tried to rebel against him got their rebellion right up their ass. All I'm saying is that they failed drastically. And then after some time he started putting out fucking propaganda for people to join his ranks. He even started harassing some of the local youths.
It's me, Frost! I'm fucking filming! Ah! Whoever put shit through me letterbox, I'm gonna smash you in it! You're fucking dead!
We find out who you are, I'm gonna tie your dad up and we're gonna fucking bum him!
That's it! You're a fucked it! I'm gonna chop your mum's ears off with a butter knife and I'm gonna cram them up your dad's ass, you son of a bitch! Ah!
Go on! I fucking dare you! put shit through my letterbox again! And it'll be last year, you fucking dig, I'm waiting!
Took it too far this time, what? Fuck,
I'm gonna find you, I'm gonna get you, I'm gonna kick your dog off its arse!
It fucking stinks! It's everywhere! My dad fucking walked into the front room! It's all on Mum's new carpet!
Enough! It's all on my fucking socks! Bought them last month, man!
Yeah. They weren't happy. A lot of people weren't happy. So that's why I've come to you. So let me ask you this. How do I stop Richie Shades?
Might I suggest that you get up off your ass and actually save the world?
Well, yes, I know that. But how do I stop him?
I'd say it's best you assemble a team if you want to stop him.
I'm gonna need a team. Well, do you have any advice on who to recruit? Because right now, I've got jack shit.
Recruit the heroes who fight against the villains.
That's actually a good idea. Right. Give me a hot list. I want the names of every single person that you think I should recruit. And give it back to me within a day. So I can ring them up.
I'm on it, Lucas.
Boss.
Ah, decoy. Decoy. Take a seat. Give me the news.
What is it?
I have some news for you, boss. You know Trevor Phillips? Big crime lord in LS? Yeah, I know about him. Shoot the messenger. Well, we found him. He's in the Vanilla Unicorn. The strip club? That's the kind of shit all I expect someone like him to hang around in. Fucking scumbag that he is. You're right on that part, boss. I've come to ask you, what should we do about him? He's been on your wanted list for months. So, we should do something about him, like, right now. I need your advice. Get after him, get the cops on him, get to the Vanilla Unicorn, get him to me, fuck him up, get out of my sight, do it now.
Jesus Christ, alright boss, alright.
While you're at it as well, do it fast, I want to relax.
Okay, Halcyon, now that you sent me the list, I'm gonna ring up every single one of them, but first, I'll send them a message so they can ring me back. I'll start with our guys in LA.
I'm Floyd here, right? For real this time?
What's going on, man?
Reason being, a few of them are a bit volatile.
I ain't mad though, it's my dog.
I'm cool with all the G.
That's what I like to hear.
Lucas Pratt, please ring me back because I want you to join my anti-Shades resistance. Thank you. What? Oh, good grief.
Shades, I can explain. First of all, don't talk to me before I talk to you. And secondly, why didn't you do it?
Well, look, he got away from us. He was too good. We couldn't catch him. I gave you one job. One fucking job.
And yet you blew it. Even if he's too fast for you, you continue to catch him. You don't give up. Seriously, decoy. It's hard enough being the leader of this multiverse when you can't even control the people against me. What if you were the leader? What would you do? Well, that just makes me glad that I'm not. But I have other information for you. We think we know where he's headed.
Oh yeah? Tell me.
Well, over the past few days, we've been hearing that a bunch of heroes from across the multiverse have been getting calls. All from the same person. So that sounds a bit suspicious. Maybe he was headed there.
From the same person, eh?
It's him. You fucked up big time today, Decoy. You know that.
If you could have caught Trevor, then whatever he is doing,
Building a rebellion against me? I don't fucking know. This could have ended today. You know what? Turn around. Shades, I said, turn around. Okay, fine. Now I want you to think, or should I say imagine, that you're being held hostage by him. You've got your eyes closed. He's interrogating you. He's on his final straw. He's pointing a gun at the back of your head. Okay. Well, you want to know the funny thing? It's all real. You're being held at gunpoint. But not by him.
So, y'all are probably wondering why I've summoned you here tonight for this meeting. Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Lucas Bratton. And yes, I think you might be mistaking me for a very clear enemy. And we know who this enemy is. Richie Shades. Guy with sunglasses on, looks like me. Probably a Muppet who got plastic surgery to make himself look like me. Look, I don't fucking know. I just want him dead. But I can't do that alone. Me and my partner Halcyon here have assembled you as a team to help me take down Richie Shades and his operations across the entire multiverse. You guys are the strongest heroes that I can afford. And believe me, you're all that I can afford at the minute. But as we build our resistance, we're going to get more popularity and more heroes are going to join and Shades is going to fuck himself over. Reiterate that, we're going to fuck Shades over. And I don't believe that I'm the only one in this meeting right now who has his own personal vendetta against Shades. I believe all of you do. I believe he took everything from all of you, or at least most of you. And practically, I don't really care about that. But I kind of do at the same time. Because I want to help you, you guys will help me. And you guys can help me by taking this bastard down. So, enough blabbering on. Let me get to the topic. I've acquired intel about an oil rig that Shades is using as a base of operations in the Caribbean Sea. And I believe that if we hit this, we can. Look. If we hit this, Shades is going to know what's going on, and we're going to gain more notoriety. So here's how it's going to go. Rumor has it there's prisoners held on board this rig. We're going to get them out. Only problem is, the locking mechanism, not the locking mechanism, the locking network for all the cells is located below the rig, underwater. A sub team is going to go in underneath the rig, sabotage that locking network, and we're going to get all the prisoners out, and we're going to extract them and blow the whole thing up. Meanwhile, I'll be in the chopper providing overwatch. Juan Cortez here is going to supply us with all the weapons and artillery that we need. This is going to be a big battle, boys. And be ready. Because there's no going back from this. This war may have been going on for years between me and Shades. But tonight, this is where it really begins. Well, not tonight. Tomorrow night. I need you all ready by tomorrow night. You have 24 hours. Get geared up. And I'll see you then.
God damn. This place hasn't changed one bit.
What a big mistake this Muppet made. Leaving his entire armory to me.
Let's gear up. Oh yes. Oh yes. Operation Darkwater is a go.
Commander, sub is in position.
Copy that. Sub team, go.
Gone dark. I'm intercepting a call from Shades, let's see what he has to say. This is Shades, get Jansen to get all the prisoners back, I want them alive. That doesn't sound good. Right, you all know what to do. Get to work. And get going.
Come on, come on, come on! Okay, let's go!
You guys go ahead, there's something I gotta do.
What are you talking about?
Trust me, it's important. You guys want to get out of here, right? Just go.
I'll go now. Okay, Winston, go, go, come on. You sure we can trust this kid?
You don't want to know who we'd be without him. Ah.
What are you kids doing out?
I want this place locked down. Call everyone in. No one leaves until everyone's accounted for. Tell me you've got eyes on them.
Still looking, still looking.
Come on, come on, come on.
There.
Who is that?
Crawford. I'm
going after the girl. Get everyone to the med wing.
Sir.
I want him alive!
Go, go, go!
No! Thomas! Open this door, Jason!
You really don't want me to.
Open the damn door!
Listen to me! Trying to save your life. Thomas, you have to believe me. I only want what's best for you.
Yeah, let me guess. Wicked is good?
You're not getting through that door, Thomas.
Hey, guys.
Come on!
Thomas, come on, let's go!
Shut the main vault door! Shut the main vault door!
Command platform!
Boss, Miller's on the command platform. Go get him. All teams fall back. We did good tonight, boys. Proud of you.
Snake. Snake!
Medic!
Feels good to have a victory once in a while. Ain't that right, boys?
She's rigged. Damn it, what? We were set up!
We gotta get it out.
Can you get it out?
No time for anesthetic. We have to open her now.
Then get it out.
Hold her down. Hold her down! Keep her gun in.
Dispose of it.
Breathing stable, no active bleeding. She's clean, I'm closing her up. Hold her steady. It's gotta be a continuous suture.
Control tower, this is Morpho 1. All hummingbirds are on the wing. We'll shake hands, then head back to the cage.
Right, my guys, listen up. As for the rest of you, you all have your own objectives. Get to work.
Right, my team. I received word of one of Shade's subordinates in Los Santos. Only problem is, I don't know where exactly in the city he is. The good news? There's an informant who can tell us where he is, but he's not going to give us the info until we win a street race for him. Now, I trust Franklin with this. He's got connections with the families, and he's a pretty good driver.
My only gripe is, we don't have a ride.
So, Fraz, do you know any places we can get performance parts for a car from?
If anybody needs performance parts, you better go and follow my boys Has Motorsport, Dewsbury, West Yorkshire. They've got all the parts to make you go faster, especially if you're getting chased by a big X5, do you know what I mean? It'll get you out of there quick time.
Forge Motorsport dump valves, Miltec exhaust, Racing Line R600 intake kits, Piper Cross induction kits, yeah? Race chip tuning boxes. We've got the full lot, mate.
That sounds promising.
Black Friday sales are going to be fire, man. Up to 25% off on some brands. But you best get out and go to the Instagram at Has Motors. Follow them, man.
If it's Black Friday, then we get a discount.
I went on Halifax Road other day, man, in my S3 at traffic lights, man, and another S3's pulled up at side of me, so I give him a cheeky little wink to have a little race, man. The fucker dusted me, man. When I eventually caught up to him, I said to him, how's your car so fast, man?
Obviously, it has motors, man. Get yourself there.
Right. The whole plan's in motion. Let's do this, boys.
Right, Franklin, remember, you need to win this so we can get our information about this guy. Anything other than first place ain't gonna get me, Jack. So get down to business, mate. Alright, drones in the air. Go get him, mate. Thank you. now. Let's see what this guy has to say.
Okay. We know where and who the target is. It's an android. And it's recently killed a man, stabbed him 28 times under Shades' order. He's in the hotel, Shades. Freddy and Franklin will extract him and bring him back to me. Meanwhile, the rest of you will provide support. I'll be at home with Lamar commanding yous. Good luck, team. Alright. Remember, we need him alive. We need to know what he knows.
Shit, Eckhart! Holy shit!
Freddy, the target's on the fifth floor. Hang on. Is
Holy
that...
shit, it's Freddy Fazbear! FNAF!
And why is this place American again? Not gonna lie to you, I think that Kevin kid picked the wrong time of year to come here.
What? Who's there?
Right, you've got him. Get out of there. Fast. Guys, you need support now. Holy shit!
I'm
Alright, you did good today, guys. Proud of yous. Got a big coffee waiting at home for yous. Let's bring this bastard back and see what he knows.
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife? How long were you in the attic? Why didn't you even try to run away? Say something, goddammit! Fuck it, I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
What do we have to lose?
He's right, Gavin. You're talking to a professional detective here.
Right, Connor, remember. We need info out of this guy. We need info on all of Shades' operations.
And he's our ticket to get it out of him.
My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? You've refused to talk since they arrested you. If you don't cooperate, they'll do things the hard way. Is that what you want? You don't seem to understand the situation. You killed a human. They'll tear you apart if you don't say something. I'm here to help you. But you've got to trust me. All I want is to get you out of here.
Gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
No. I think they just want to understand. They know your master abused you. It wasn't your fault.
Why did you tell them you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me.
I can't.
Connor, just making conversation with it isn't going to get us info. You're going to need to do something, so it... Oh?
28 stab wounds. You didn't want to leave him a chance, huh? Did you feel anger? Hate? He was bleeding, begging you for mercy. But you stabbed him again and again and again.
Please. Please leave me alone.
I know you killed him. Why don't you say it?
Please stop!
Just say, I killed him! Is it that hard to say?
Stop it! Stop!
Just say you killed him! Just say it!
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong.
Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me, scared I might die.
It was being used. Shades was using it to do his bidding. Sick bastard.
There was blood everywhere.
Right, Connie, you did good. We got everything we need. Oh, shit.
What the fuck is
it destroying itself?
Stop it, goddammit! I can't stop it!
That's enough! You need to stop that right now!
Watch out!
What the fuck?
Holy shit!
Jesus Christ.
Connor's fucked, sir. There's nothing we can do about him.
Great. Well, Connor's destroyed, so we have no chance of interrogating anybody anymore. But I have a new plan. For us, you know how your videos are basically very controversial? How about we do that against Shades? My idea is anti-propaganda. Let's see how it works.
All my peeps on Facebook thinking you're bad, mate. I'll line every last one of your birds up and bomb them one by one. Fucking bear rat must!
I'm gonna get my aprilla out and do burnouts on your front lawn, and then I'm gonna chuck mud bombs at your nan's windows, you silly bastards.
Think I'm a fucking ding, mush, eh? I'll grab your bird in headlock and I'll shave a fucking ball. You think you don't read my comments on Facebook? I'll take it out of that bonnet and carry on driving, you little dings.
What's wrong with that Facebook subject? This is a message for Phil Trout. You want to take piss out of my curtains, mate? Have you seen State on Your Bird's Beef curtains, mate? You can swing from flap to flap, mate, and they fucking stink.
Kenzie Lee, Scummy Mummy Award goes to you, you little slag. When I see you in school in the morning, I'm going to take you out them PJs and them fucking Ugg boots and throw you in a fucking thorn bush.
And how are you going to tell me to get a job? When your dad sat outside job centre picking up dockers in your sister's knickers.
And if we're on about your sister's knickers, you wanna tell Scruffy bitch to give him a wash? I put my hand down there other week, mate, pulled them down, bro. Fucking hell, I thought they were two-tone tiger stripes, mush. Fucking skidders all over them, dirty bitch, mate. She needs to put them in fucking wash.
You think you're sick, though, man? You will know about it when I fucking Batista bombed your nan in the middle of Asda and show an eggplant up a fanny the fucking dust bag.
You think you're sick, mate? I'll twang your dad in deep with a shatter hammer and fist bump your nan.
I'll fucking cave your dad's head in with a can of spam and throat grip your nan until they pop in her head. Silly bitch.
Mate, if you're gonna fucking carry on, I'll skin your mum and wear her as a suit and I'll go shag your dad in it, mush.
You're bad, mate, obviously, yeah? Come to my local, I'll show you who's bad, you little muppet. I'll knock seven shades of shit out of you, silly cunt.
We come in twos. He'll be at your front door, I'll be at your back, taking heads off 2 foot price or one, so if you want it, bring your dad.
Obviously, I'm a fighter, man. I'm ruthless, man. I'll leave your dad toothless.
Sausages.
Muppets, man. Set your dad's arse on fire, you silly bastard. Obviously, I've been training with Conor McGregor since the young.
I'll run up on your bird and rack your Swiss off her feet, man.
Okay, so now that the public has taken notice of us and Shades is taking more annoyance to us, I say we piss him off even more. For us, Molly, you take a car, drive it all over his front lawn, piss him off as much as you can.
Yo, it's me, Fraz, man. My mum's gone to fucking, my mum's at work, man, so I thought me and Molly would take car out for a bit, you know what I do? Sell a few bags of weed, you know how we do around here, man.
Yeah, we do on Grafton, that, man.
Watch me, mush, I'm like Ken Block behind this wheel, man. I told you before in my S3. Now watch me in my fucking mum's Golf, mate.
Alright, ready, set, go.
Let's kill our team.
taking her along? Is it going to take them to...
What's the word?
Shit. Holy shit.
I'm gonna kill you, boss! You fucking woman! No more videos, I'm gonna be fucking grounded! Bring me a fucking ambulance. Are you alright, bro?
No, I'm fucking not.
Wow, man, my mum's gonna fucking kill me, much like someone fucking rank bitches, man.
Oh,
fucking next door, man.
Commander, come in! You know how that car flipped accidentally in that video earlier? Get this. Molagrip flipped it on purpose with an EMP.
Fucking rat. Get me on comms.
Since when have you been working with Shades? Let me guess, you gave in to that bastard's political propaganda, didn't you? You fucking rat.
And don't even think about telling me bullshit, because you know I'm not a guy to accept bullshit.
Commander, he's not going to admit it to you.
Oh, he ain't going to talk. Get Fraz in. Hey, Fraz, come join the meeting.
Fucking drop you, mate. Ever swear with me, lad?
You may have heard that accident earlier was no accident. Turns out Molly flipped the fucking car over. We planted some bomb or something. What was it called again? Yeah. Planted whatever it's called underneath the fucking car and flipped it. That's how you got into the accident earlier.
Better yet, man. This little bastard's working for Shades. Gave in to his political propaganda. Looks like not everybody's immune to that. Not even us. The resistance.
Sort your head out,
mate.
What?
Drop me! Drop me! Drop me! Drop me!
Look, Molly, all I want to know is the truth. Why did you do... What? Yeah? What the fuck? How's that happened? Well, I am... Molly has betrayed us. You fucking rat. You snitched on us. You little bastard. I thought I could fucking trust you, mate. And this is how you repay me? By ratting us out of Shades? God. This is the closest we've been to winning this war in God knows how long. And now it's all come down to this. Fraz, kick his ass.
Oh, what are you doing?
Oh, shit! Rise and shine. Shades.
I must say I'm impressed. The fact you've come this far is... unbelievable. Well, actually it ain't.
What are you talking about? Let me ask you this. And I mean it.
Do you know who I am?
I know exactly who you are. You're just some muppet who got plastic surgery to make himself look like me. And the name, Richie Shades, is it some kind of stage name? Because to me it fucking sucks.
Funny. Every word you just said there was wrong. You have no idea who I am.
Tell me. The very person sitting across the table that I'm talking to, both in appearance and DNA. We're
one and the same. I'm you.
How? How is this possible?
Remember that day years ago? When you tried to make your own friend? You couldn't make friends with others. So you decided to make one of your own. You used a computer software. And you made one that looked exactly like you. You wanted to bring it into the real world. Don't you remember?
No.
Yeah.
Well, you what?
So I created you. But how wouldn't I remember?
Well, after you created me, you blacked out straight away. And you lost your memory. The reason being,
I created you to be my friend. Then, how have you ended up like this?
Villains don't answer questions like that. Oh, but better yet, there's more to this story than meets the eye.
See, when you created me, our minds swapped bodies. Or should I say, our consciousnesses. So my mind went into your body, and your mind into mine. And I'm staring at my body from across this table. And so are you.
So, I'm wearing a clone's body?
A body that holds more than you think. And I want it back. Because if my consciousness matches up with my body, then I'll be granted immortality. But if you don't get your body back, then you'll perish inside that one. Because you can't live forever inside that thing. No matter how hard you survive. It'll kill you from the inside the longer you stay in it. And in fact, looking at the time, you don't have long left in that body. It'll tear you out from the inside until you'll perish and be nothing more.
So how are you going to pull my mind out of your body? By digging into my brain.
I built myself a machine that will transfer my mind back into that body. There's no stopping me. Well, it's a good thing you caught me now, didn't you? You ain't getting away with this. Oh, I will.
I'm moving you to my base on Pandora. That's where we'll swap minds. And that's where you'll perish inside yours. And that's...
Don't move now. What the hell? Shit!
Commander, let's get you out of here!
I know y'all are probably asking how I'm doing right now. That's not important. Look, I have a truth to tell you all. And I know you ain't gonna like this. Richie Shades is me. I created him. He told me everything that happened. I lost my memory afterwards. And I can't believe it, honestly. I can't believe that I've put so many people's lives at risk all because I wanted a fucking friend. Honest to God. I started this war. But we are gonna finish it. He took the multiverse from us. And we are gonna take it back no matter the cost. We will attack his base on Pandora. And we will take our home back. We will take everything back. This war needs to end. And it ends tonight. We fight for what we desire most. That's to protect our home. Get ready. Everyone across the entire multiverse, get ready. Because tonight, the ultimate fight begins.
All teams, this is Leader. I'm on approach to the base right now. All y'all are gonna cover me. You wage war across this whole multiverse, and we're gonna finish this. I am on final approach.
You really thought I wouldn't the think hell? You were coming?
Shades.
You can't win this war, nor can he.
What do you mean?
You both should give up.
You think I'm gonna give up that easily?
The only way you will is if you learn the truth.
What the? Shit! What the hell? What? I'm back home? No, something isn't right. This has to be part of his plan. What the hell? It is all part of his plan. Shades? What the hell have you done this time? Yeah, that's the instinct reaction right there. You may think you're talking to Shades. What are you saying? Is that some kind of dumb question? It ain't dumb, and this ain't Shades talking either. This is the Creator. The Creator? What the hell are you saying? Well, looks like it's best I show you the truth. And what the hell did that accomplish? That's me. Wait. Shade said that I created him. Does that mean
it does?
Two clones were made. One with sunglasses. Well, one who inherited sunglasses. And one who didn't. So I'm a clone of him. The original. And so is Shade. Simply put, yes. If that's the case, then why is he dead? Well, that's because when he created the two of us, or should I say, the two of you, his life ended. The funny thing is, his mind lived on in you, and in Shades as well, albeit much more evil. So that's why I couldn't remember anything about what had happened. But wait. Whoever you are speaking through Shades' body, you're calling yourself the Creator. What does that mean? Best I spill the beans then. I created the multiverse gateway device, not the CIA. Shades just used that as a hoax, so you could come after him. All of that was part of his plan. Well, seeing what your multiverse has come to, don't you regret it? I do. But look, the multiverse isn't my ownage. All those franchises, they're not my property. None of them are. I just created this so people could access them without having to access them individually. But look how far it's come. To war, to slavery, to tomfoolery, to fuckery. Yeah, that's how far it's come. I should never have created this thing. I may have created this thing, but I can uncreate it, should I say, destroy it. I don't care whether the results will be catastrophic. I'm doing this for the greater good. Catastrophic, what the hell does that mean?
It means I'm doing this for the greater good.
Give me a gun!
What the hell?
I'm doing what's right.
Say hello to my little friend!
You bastard! Ah! Ah, shit. What the hell?
What the hell?
What the hell was that for?
It's all for the greater good.
What greater good? Just tell me. What is going on?
The truth is, your body isn't corrupted. Shades lied to you, because he didn't want to tell the truth himself. He's the one who's corrupted. And when he dies, he's going to take the whole multiverse with it. That's why he wanted to transfer your consciousness back into your body. So you could perish instead. As soon as this body dies, the whole multiverse will be reset, but not the kind of reset that you'd expect.
Why? What's gonna happen?
Instead of going back to the way it was before, everything will be deleted. Every character, every franchise, every world will be gone just like that. And I regret this so much. The internet's gonna blow up about it. Everybody's gonna want answers, and they're gonna want answers from you, because you're the one who led this rebellion. So, you go out there and you tell them that it was a sacrifice that they all had to make. Part in this. None of them need to know the truth, and none of them will know the truth.
Okay, I'll do whatever you ask. I won't let them know the truth.
That's good. You're a good man, you know. Also, one last thing. Take these shades back. You can do whatever you want with them. I just don't want to see them again.
Okay.
Final thing. Don't trust Protocol X.
Protocol X.
Multiverse reset in 3. 2.
Halcyon?
1.
Oh. Whoa. Looks like everything's back to normal. Wait. No, 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 no. It's all gone. He wasn't lying. Halcyon, all of it's gone. I can't let them know the truth. Nobody will know the truth, and nobody has to know the truth. If you're listening to this, then it is Christmas Eve. It's been 6 months since it all went down. Since we took out Shade, since the multiverse exploded, since our universe became the last survivors of this great war. Of course, I helped to set everything right. But more importantly, I wasn't alone. We all stuck together. And because of that, I learned something. We went together. We're strong. But when we're alone, we're weak. And sticking together is what helps us win these wars. It made me realize that I can't always do things on my own. I can't always win against Richie Shades on my own. But as of then, that all changed. No more wars, only eternal peace. A new age is beginning, and a warless age, a peaceful age, and because of us, we helped to start it, because if we weren't there, none of this would have happened. This war wouldn't have been won. We would have lost. And of course, now that I realize that it was all my fault, I created Shades. It was an experiment gone wrong. I shouldn't have tried. This war was all my fault. I started it. But I finished it. And I wasn't alone. No. We finished it. And because we stuck together, it also made me realize that, look, you guys made the sacrifices that you had to, but let me tell you this, no matter whether you're alive, no matter whether you're gone, no matter whether you're up there in heaven with your families, your friends, or even God himself. There's one thing that you should know, always know. We will always be friends, no matter whether we can be here or we can't. This one goes out to you. This is Lucas Brown, last survivor of the final battle of the multiverse, last hero alive, wishing you all a Merry Christmas.
signing off. Goodbye.